Hello, 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 and welcome to another episode of the Sims 4 Disney Princess Challenge. So here we are at the list of towns, because I have some updates I want to share with you. I've installed three new packages using the Origin deal again, the Cats and Dogs expansion pack, the Vampires game pack, and the Fitness Stuff pack. I really should have gotten these two packs in the first place. Now I can finally add some new Disney characters that I wasn't able to add, like Lilo and Stitch, Kylo Ren and Rey, etc. Oh, it's about time I filled the towns with some more Disney peeps. Everyone is sadly dying out. Maybe I'll resurrect some of them one day. So the Fitness Stuff pack is a fairly new addition. It comes with some brand new gym wear that makes Alice look super cool. Plus it has some new gym equipment, including a rock climbing wall. Will it be big enough to fit in the house? Probably not. Anyway, those are the quick updates, and without further ado, let's get right into the game. And here we are, back in the Disney household. First of all, I want to mention some extra changes I made in the furnishings. As you can see, Clarabelle's bed has been moved upstairs to join the rest of the girls, taking over Cinderella's space. So where is Cinderella sleeping then? Well, Cinderella has officially taken over her mum's old bedroom, the master bedroom. Yeah, it's a little bit of favoritism here, but think about it. She's gonna carry on the Disney legacy, and she's the new matriarch of the house, so she has every right to take her mum's space. A nice bedroom all to herself. And Clarabelle's old room has been replaced by Donald's new study. And Donald has already broken the computer, so Mickey, when you got the time, could you fix this, please? Thank you. Another major thing, the bathroom. So I split the bathroom in two. So one room is the toilet and the other room is the shower room. There's just a high demand for own private toilet space, basically. I think all houses in general should have this. I live in a house that has a separate toilet from the shower room and it's just so convenient compared to when I go to other people's houses. And I got rid of the bar and replaced it with a very nice dining table so everyone can dine together and not take their plates to their bedrooms and sit on their beds. It's just more homey and everyone is sitting together like a proper family. One final thing, I've added some brand new pictures to add a personal touch to the household. So this wedding photo here, I made that myself. Whole family together, I used the same picture from the thumbnail in the previous episode, and then I put it in a backdrop at the very same altar where Snow White and Florian got married. And it just looks so cool, everyone's posing like a movie poster. I think it's a very cool photo. And then there's also another one to replace Snow White's picture. It's a collage of certain family members. Here are the two princesses posing by a cherry tree backdrop. There's Anastasia and Gisella looking like a cool duo. And there's Mickey and Donald. I love how you can see Donald's hand through Mickey's back. It just looks so cool. And then there's a very sweet selfie of the husband and wife by their altar. I love these personal touches. You know, it's not enough to just have paintings of the kids sleeping in their beds. We've got to have some more recent pictures, especially from a very monumental event like Snow White's wedding. It's a very comfortable chair, isn't it? I've been notified that it's Alice's birthday today, which gets me to the point of figuring out what to do with the rest of the kids in terms of moving out. As you can see, we keep getting a moodlet of everyone getting sick and tired of being around one another and just feeling claustrophobic. They want their own space, they want their own independence, and that's what I'll do. I want to make sure everyone moves out. Cinderella is the one who's carrying on the legacy, therefore she has to stay in the house. Which leaves the other two grown-ups, Mickey and Donald. Mickey and Donald, they're gonna have very similar paths. They will propose to their girlfriends, have a wedding, and then move out together. I'm a bit reluctant to let Mickey go, however, because one, he's still a ghost, and secondly, I really am interested in his wizard career. I want to witness him being a master wizard. So my plan for him is that he must find anything he can to reverse his situation. So find a potion or find a spell that will bring him back from the dead. Obviously, I will carry on with Cinderella's Ambrosia quest, but that's obviously going to take a very long time. Alice is the next one to be a grown-up. I think she'll be the first one to move out. However, we are very, very poor, so there's no way I can give her any money to move out on her own. So she'll kind of have to live off somebody else. She'll have to move in with some housemates. Anastasia and Drizella are pretty easy because both of their ambitions are to move out. They want to move to different locations. So I'll do just that. I will send them to their desired locations. Now, Clarabelle here is a bit of a question mark. I find her so insignificant in this family that I don't care where she goes. I don't care if she stays. I don't care if she moves in with her parents. I don't even care if she moves out on her own with no money at all. My aim is to make sure that I get to master rank. Therefore, he can perform all the spells, which will include the very special spell to reverse his situation. Oh, what the? What?
Is he dead?
I thought he was going to disappear, but he didn't. Another fire in the bathroom. Well, at least we got a tiny bit of insurance. Oh dear. Mickey, screwed up. Well, at least he fixed it. Oh, he had an overload. Okay, so that episode he had was from using too much magic. Oh, my bad, Mickey. You've been cleaning too much and doing that one little thing has just set it off. Oh, that was pretty terrifying. Oh, it would be so nice to bake the same kind of cakes as Vision. Like the healthier versions. Because I think that's the type Alice would like, but I think Vision is a master chef, so we'll have to do with the regular cakes. Let's just do a coconut cake. The birthday cake's made. Let's just do a private one. I don't feel like setting up a party. We've been having too many parties. She's either going to be music lover, geek, loves outdoors, erratic, or bro. Pick a number from 1 to 5.
5.
Oh, cool. She's going to be a bro. Well, she is a bit of a tomboy and it makes perfect sense. Our tomboy Alice is grown. Okay. Who could she move in with? Oh, didn't know Quasimodo has a family. I don't see Alice getting along with Darth Vader and Kylo Ren. Maybe Rey, but Rey has feelings for Kylo Ren, so maybe not. Oh, hello. Some Johnny Depps here. Yes, those are the type of characters Alice would get along with. And one of them happens to be the Mad Hatter, so they'll be fast chums. Yes, let's move in with the Johnny Depps. Oh, I see they have a nice bit of cash here. You wouldn't mind lending some of the money, would you? Let's do it 50-50. Just a tiny bit above them. Perfect. Well, here we are in Alice's new home, and here are our housemates. The 5 Johnny Depps. Ooh, this is a very nice house. Oh, Alice will settle in just fine. Alice, this is a goodbye. You're actually one of my favorite characters, Alice. I really like your cool vibes. And of course, I love your outfits and your hair. You are just so cool looking. Even though you are a little bit awkward with people. But I think you'll get along with these people just fine. They're just as awkward and quirky as you. Like, you got all kinds of colorful characters to get to know. But you'll have to mind Sweeney Todd here. He's a little bit of a psychopath. I'm sure you'll be on his good side. So, yeah, Alice, I'm going to say farewell to you, and I wish you the best of luck in your new home. So we're back with one less family member in the house. And Cinderella's still annoyed that there are too many people in the house. Cinderella, you've got to be patient, okay? People need to become adults. It's a brand new day and it's Winterfest again. We should probably put a Christmas tree now. Thanks to the Johnny Depps, we got plenty of cash. The Christmas tree is a little bit bare, so why don't you guys start decorating? Donald's just tossing them as if they're gonna stick like magnets. Well, Cinderella, is she up? Yeah, she's up. Let's have a grand breakfast and also let's have a ham dinner. Ooh, I'd kill for some ham. Aw, look at them. Everyone decorating the tree like a proper family. That's the Christmas spirit. Ooh, very merry indeed. Oh, that looks super good. Ooh, yum. Yummy. Now she's doing the ham. She looks so reluctant to do anything. She's like, ugh, hate my life. Ooh, he's got teleport, so I don't have to cheat. He can just move anywhere he likes, so let's practice that. Why don't you go over here? Ooh, very fancy, very cool. Nice work, Mickey. And the tree is finished. Very pretty. Very pretty tree. Ooh, this is very nice. Oh my goodness. Yes, Anastasia, I bet that smells good. I think we should organize the party now. So get your parents and get the girlfriends. Oh, and there's the dad. Hello, he's sitting at the head of the table. Oh, and there's Mimi. Yay. Mickey, go and say hi to her. Oh, warm up with body heat. That's a good idea. You're gonna make her wet as well as warm. That sounds so wrong. Okay, where is everyone else? Oh, there they are! They're having a chat outside! Oh, weird place to be. Oh no, she's too cold! Alright, Cinderella, call for your mum, because I don't want her to freeze to death. I mean, she can die whenever she likes, but not now. I want it to be a happy time. Oh, we need to put some presents. Cinderella, could you do that? You're the kind and giving person. You're the one who bought all these presents. Here we go. A nice big pile of presents. Snow White, you gonna warm yourself up a little? You're still very blue. You're even more blue than Mickey. Oh, nice to see the whole family together. Oh, Anastasia, you can't do without a little bit of bickering on poor Cinderella here. Drizella, you can do a bit too. Oh, there's Father Winter, and he's given more presents to top it up. Thank you. Why don't you join in? Help yourself to the food. Come on, please. I insist you try Cinderella's delicious food. Oh, look at him. Josiah's tucking in. Despite the party being over, everyone is still sticking around. Oh, I think he's about to set off. Bye, Josiah. Thanks for eating our food. And he's off in a puff of smoke. Wow, that's a huge pile of plates. Oh, he wants to... Okay. You can't do that here, I'm afraid. There's no space in this house. You do it in her house. Or your own home. Speaking of which, let's make it official between you two. Yes! And she said yes! Aw, so sweet. Oh, and she's so happy that she's leapt into his arms. That's so cute. Yay, everyone had a good time. No one is unhappy. Everyone else is asleep. Oh, Daisy, you didn't have to. Oh, you're so kind. You're probably thinking, huh, how come my roommate gets to be engaged and I don't? Actually, you're probably not too affected because you are, after all, non-committal. Can't believe you are non-committal. But time will come, and Mickey will out of nowhere pop the question at you.
5 hours later.
I did not expect Meanie and Daisy to still be here. Oh my god, Daisy! She's gone to sleep on the sun lounge. Okay, seriously, we did not invite you for sleepover. Daisy, you got a wedding to look forward to. Don't kill yourself like this. Why don't you first of all make a cake for Anastasia? Oh, yeah, let's do zombie cake. Let's make a cake that represents her. Oh, look at that. That's a very cool looking cake. It looks just like Anastasia. Here we are at Glimmerbrook. Why don't we fly over to the portal here? Try out that broomstick for the first time. Hey, off he goes. Wow, that was a very smooth ride. Cool, it's been a while since we've been here, so why don't we find Sage first and ask for- Oh! We got a brand new Sage! Maximus Bonds. That's a very cool name. So let's say hi to him and then we can ask for the Glimmerstone. He looks a little bit like Nobuya. I think they'll get along. And he's very handsome as well. He's very good looking. Oh, I got Festa. He looks so funny in the yellow hoodie. Oh, thank you. He's given us a new potion. But yeah, as you can see, there's quite a few different potions. Look, the potion of immortality and prompt resurrection. I think that's... Oh no, rejuvenation? Either of those sound really useful. We need to get one of those. Yay, Mickey. You're making a new friend. Hopefully he doesn't die too soon. I mean, he's got plenty of years ahead. Where are you, Anastasia? Time to blow out the candles. Happy birthday, Anastasia. How do you like the cake? She's either going to be music lover, materialistic, snob, erratic, or self-absorbed. Pick a number from 1 to 5.
2.
Okay, she's all about money. I mean, that makes a lot of sense. Evil people always want plenty of money. Oh wow, Mickey learnt a new spell called Copy-Pasto. So it's the ability to turn one small object into many. That is so useful, oh my goodness. I love the practical magic spells. Well, you can actually always transportulate, yeah. You can teleport anytime. Right, it's a new day, and I really think that Anastasia should upgrade in her career. So we're gonna get her to find a new job. Ooh, critic. Well, that's her kind of thing. I mean, she is always about insulting people. Anastasia is free to go. Don't worry, Cinderella. She's gonna be out soon. I'll be kind to her and give her some money. And she's going to go all the way to Solani. Here we are. We are at Anastasia's new home. Ooh, this looks very nice. Wow, all that coral space. You're so lucky. And you get a speedboat nearby. Anastasia, I gotta be honest when I say I'm not gonna miss you. You are, after all, the evil child of the family. I just hope that you have a very pleasant life on the beach and don't cause too much terror in the neighborhood. Farewell, Anastasia. Now we have 5 children left, and Cinderella is so happy today. Your arch nemesis is gone for good. Drizella, why don't you go and fill in Anastasia's role as the mean bully? Oh, and she's in the right mood for it as well. I can't believe I have to stick with you, the loser. Yes, they despise each other. You got another enemy. Wow. Right, you can go to school now. You're free to go. Oh, I'm sorry you had to endure that, Cinderella. Why don't you take your mind off it in the kitchen? Just bake something. Make something nice. If you're hungry, make something with magic. There you go. Ooh, asparagus. Oh, so fancy. Mickey's getting really good. I don't think Cinderella's even learnt that yet. She looks so frustrated. Like, why can't you just pick something from my fridge? Stop showing off with your magic. Oh no, not again. Stop. Are you doing this deliberately so you can improve in your magic powers? I mean, how far are you? Oh, you're very close. You know what? I encourage it. I encourage you breaking items so you can keep going with your repairing spells. Oh, that is really cool. He's made a new potion called Potion of Forced Friendship. A potion that unlocks the power of friendly conversation. I'm curious to try it, actually. Oh, is it disgusting?
It tastes like sheep feces.
Use the power of forced friendships. Oh, that would be very interesting to see. Oh, no. Oh, no. I did not expect that to backfire. My psychic told me to avoid Sims like you. Stay away from me. Oh, no. They despise each other. No. I didn't want him to be an enemy. No, I wanted him to be friends. That is such bad luck. Let's just do this manually. Oh, it turns out he's mean anyway, so... Maybe it's a good thing they're enemies. Even though the potion did backfire on him, I think he's improved in his friendly conversations. Like, I'm noticing how drastically down it's going. I just have to keep going with the conversations. I'm gonna make you train with him till you almost pee yourself. Yes! He's a master now! Oh, actually, no. There's another rank. I did not realize that. Okay, I thought master literally means master and that's the end of the ranks, but no, there's virtuoso, which is interesting. Oh my god, Lurch looks so cool now. How has he transformed all of a sudden? De-deathify. That's a bit of a tongue twister. Yeah, that's the one that I need. I need that spell. I really need that spell. I've given Clarabelle access to the computer so she can practice her writing, as that's her aspiration. Obviously, she'll move out and then she'll get her own computer, but for now, she's going to use Donald's computer. Drizella is doing a little bit of a workout.
Yes! Yes, he found it! He discovered the spell! Yes!
restore a ghost to their original physical form. I did it! Yes! We need to get everyone up so they can see this for themselves. They need to see their brother return from the dead. It's actually happening! I can't believe it!
Wake up! Wake up, Donald! I discovered it! I know what to do to reverse my situation!
This is it. This is the moment I've been waiting for. Wait, where is it? How do I get it? What? How do I get him to perform on his body? You mean he can't? Someone else has to do it for him? Donald's just looking at him like, you woke me up at this time for what?
A few moments later.
I've been looking through forums and this is the answer. Oh, fantastic! All that hard work and I find out that he can't even perform it on himself. That is an absolute waste of time! Donald, yeah, you have every right to be angry. Like, I thought this was the day he was going to return to his physical form. But no, it doesn't work like that. It's the wrong weather for Cinderella to carry on with the Ambrosia challenge. Like, it's way too cold to go fishing. Everything is dead outside, so she can't plant any more things. It's just not a good time for her. And that's why I was so eager to get Mickey to learn that spell, but I find out that it's not worth it. Oh dear. So, it's a new day and it's New Year's Eve. Perfect time for celebrations, New Year's resolutions. Donald, why don't you start with coming up with a resolution? Your resolution is to get fit. Donald's going straight to his resolution, getting fit. You are going to complete an aspiration milestone. Let's go for that one. Well, here he is back in the magic realm and there is his frenemy, Maximus. I just need to win some jewels and then I've achieved Mickey's resolution. Just find some random people here. Ideally people who are not as good as Mickey. Let's ask Wanda. She was the one who first challenged us. Hi Wanda, you look a little older today. How about we do a magic jewel? Jewel 4. Ooh, we can ask for things. Let's just do a friendly one. Yeah, just get to know them better. Don't ask for things too soon. It's Mickey versus Wanda! No, Mickey lost again! Wanda must have really improved in her skills. We need to find some amateurs. Let's ask Festa. We did win against him once. How are they looking so cool with their trendy jumpers? They're taking outside. Ooh. It's Mickey versus Festa. Ooh, Festa's just completely overpowering Mickey. Oh my god, Mickey. How are you so bad now? Ooh, nice shield. Yay! Cool. You won one duel. We need to have two more. Let's ask Lurch. Not asking for anything else, I just want to achieve my New Year's resolution. Here we go. Mickey versus Lurch! And fight! Ooh, got a bit of a clash. Ooh, it was a tie. Another clash. Oh no. Mickey overpowered him. Yes! Mickey won!
I'm the best.
Yes, we just need one more person to duel against now. Who shall it be? Oh, Gomez! Gomez is old now. Oh. Well, we'll say hi to him. So, it's Mickey versus Gomez! Fight! Oh! Bad start for Mickey. Oh, it turns out Gomez is a little bit more skilled than we expected. Ooh! Mickey gets another hit! Another hit! Festa's watching. He's like, yeah, you get him, Gomez! Oh no, he's just walking away, he's not that interested. Ooh, huge one, that was good, yes! You did it! You achieved your resolution! Well done! Now we just have to get to Virtuosa, that's it! That's our next task.
And I think we could do that. It's quite soon. We are over halfway. Oh my god. Mickey, you have done such a good job. You're so productive. Finally, we have reached spring. So now Cinderella can resume the Ambrosia challenge. Very pretty. This is a very pretty beach. I wonder if we'll come across Anastasia. Oh, there's her house. Sorry, all the responsibility of reviving your brother has completely fallen onto your shoulders for now. Gosh, she's doing very well today. She's catching all kinds of fish. She caught a goldfish. She also caught a mahi-mahi. She caught a guppy. And even a clownfish. Oh, it's raining though. It's getting a bit miserable. So we're back in the magic realm. It's a new day. And he's just drinking all that knowledge up. Like juice. He has worked harder than ever before in this episode. Ooh, Tome Immortality. Okay, that sounds really fun. I don't think this is the one he needs because we don't want him to remain as a ghost, a young ghost for that matter, forever. But that's a very valuable spell to learn. A potion to prevent death from old age. Okay, it's a good one. That's a potion that anyone would want. How are you feeling? Are you just very stressed out? That's the point of work. Work is supposed to stress you out. Oh, what happened here? Oh no! Nudge is dying! Oh my goodness! Oh no! Rest in peace, Nudge! You're such a good-looking Disney peep. I could have given you the potion of immortality, but I don't know you that well. You're not really friendly with Mickey. Oh, but that's pretty sad. Well, that's it. Goodbye, Lurch. Oh, come on. You're so close. You almost filled the book with your potion recipes. The sages are probably admiring him for his hard work. Come on, you could do it. You could do it. Please give me one more recipe. Oh no, he's not in the mood. The Sage of Untamed Magic is just very impressed with him as well. Oh my goodness, I completely missed it. So all that time that he had been studying and experimenting and learning recipes and spells, he has reached Virtuoso. He is an ultimate master sorcerer. Amazing. So why is the aspiration not updated yet? Oh, he actually completed it. He completed it! Mickey is a fully accomplished wizard! I did it! Oh my god! Well, now he needs to find a new aspiration! Right, I'll check if this actually will be fulfilled because he's found so many different types of potions. Ah, he needs a cauldron! Okay. We can buy a cauldron, sure. We've got plenty of money. The question is, where can we put it? Oh, it's not that expensive. So, we could put it in this space here. As you can see, I really shrunk the girls' room here because now there are only two of them. It's a weird place to put it, but I don't want to expand or change the rooms too much. Can we change color? Oh yes, no, blue. Blue is a nice one. There we go. This looks nice and mystical. But we need a door now. Well, actually, Mickey can just teleport here. Doesn't need a door. It's just a secret room that has no doors.
A little later.
I was just fast-tracking her fishing, and then she caught this. Is this what I think it is? Did she actually catch the angelfish? Yes! She caught an angelfish! Well done, Cinderella! That's one of the main ingredients for the ambrosia. Oh, we have to keep that very, very safe. We've got to make sure that it's alive and fresh 24/7. You don't need to carry on fishing anymore. You did it. You found the ingredient. There we go. Fish bowl. So we're gonna put it in her room. Is it there? Yeah, there it is. You can just make it out. It's very tiny. But that's our fish. That's our prize. And we're gonna call it Ambrosia because that's its purpose. It's easy to get the... What exactly is it called again? It's the Potion of Youth. Okay. We can buy that. We put that next to our Ambrosia angelfish. Ooh, very pretty. So we're going to keep those safe. No one's going to consume the fish or the potion. You know what? I am going to just go to the creepy places like the graveyards, the Forgotten Hollows, see if they do have wild death flowers. Oh,
Here she is at the household, and all the Johnny Depps are out. Like, just have nothing better to do but step outside and enjoy the snow. Oh, there's Wolfsbane. There's a Sixum mosquito trap. Oh, and there's a vampire. Oh no, it's a crow, actually. Thought it was a bat. Well, there is a graveyard, but no death flowers. Which is a downright shame. She's been chatting with Willy Wonka and Ichabod Crane. Oh my god, what happened to Cinderella's face? It looks like she's been punched. Punched back to 2000. I would like to harvest these interesting plants, but they're not fully grown, so we'll have to come back another time. Cinderella, you'll have to just return home. Oh yeah, that's right. You don't need to go to the magic realm. You can just experiment right there. Well, you can teleport there and then you just go through the wall. There you go. See, that's the great thing about being a ghost. You don't need to open doors. You can just walk right through. Yes, yes, he's learnt it. He's learnt the spell I wanted. Yes. The whole list of potions. Look at that, so many. This is it. Drink, Mickey. Oh, I'm so excited to see this. Watch. Watch as your brother transforms. Wait, what? What? Oh, are you telling me that this is not the potion to bring him back from the dead?
I guess not.
Oh, I misread it. A sim that drinks this potion will revive immediately if they die. So basically, the potion allows someone who just died to come back to life. It's like same thing as asking death to spare him, but this is potion form. Oh no! I wasted that potion! You mean to tell me that there is no such thing as a potion to bring someone back from the dead?
Nope.
Oh, Mickey, you've worked so hard only to find out that it's no point. They don't serve your kind of purpose. Oh, I'm so annoyed. I can't perform the de-deathify spell on myself. I can't find a potion that has the same purpose. So the only choice I have, well, the only two choices I have, is to either find another spellcaster to perform the spell on him, or Cinderella has to carry on with the Ambrosia challenge. I'm not going to be controlling any other Sims, apart from this Disney family. So yeah, Mickey, you have every right to weep at your grave. You will never return to your physical form unless Cinderella gets to work with her Ambrosia recipe. I'm basically tired out, so that will be the end of this episode for now. We've made Mickey work so hard to find the answers, to find the cure. You might as well call this a curse. Being a ghost is a curse. And Mickey has failed in that. He can't do it. He can't find the answer in his magic realm. So it is up to Cinderella. Cinderella has to get to level 10. She's very close. She is level 8. She's not too far off. We'll need to buy the death flower at the magic realm. And then Cinderella has to get right on cooking. Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye for now.